Hey, what's going on, guys? Kurosama here. And today we're taking a look at our last Mega Man kit of the month, which is going to be from Kotobukiya. This is Roll. She is basically a part of the entire Mega Man universe. This one in particular is from the OG Mega Man universe. So, like the, you know, basically the original, not the X, not the EXE, or any of those other variations. So, with Roll, she's a really interesting robot. Don't really have too many things to say about her. She's the first female robot in the Mega Man universe. So she does have a special place in a lot of, you know, fans' hearts. Me personally, I don't really care. I used her in Marvel vs. Capcom 2 for a little bit as a joke. But yeah, she's kind of just a side character that cleans up and it's pretty much useless. But let's go ahead and check out the kit. And here she is, all complete. Honestly, looking really good. Color separation, everything is fantastic. What do you think, Steve?
Crow, did we just adopt a daughter?
No, we definitely did not adopt a daughter. I just built this for the review.
I always wanted to be a father. And I get to share that moment with you, Crow. I'm so goddamn proud.
No, she's not an adoptive daughter. She's not even, like, animated. She's just a toy. She's a toy robot.
How dare you speak that way about our daughter? Come on, Stephanie. We don't need to be here.
I didn't even do anything. So here she is. This is going to be her Mega Man 8 style outfit, and we'll cover the original Mega Man style a little bit later in the review. But for now, we're just going to take a look at some of the details on this costume and just my overall impressions and thoughts. Now, covering some of the details on her, she is going to have basically a lot of pre-painted parts. It's going to be the chest part with the little blue buttons. It's going to be on the sleeves, those little blue parts. And then the ribbon is actually painted. It's not really molded. It's like a painted part, essentially. The eyes and the face is also going to have those pre-painted colors as well. So, other than that, she's pretty accurate to what she's supposed to represent. The only thing that I would say is not color accurate is going to be at the feet. Those little parts, those little white parts, are supposed to have an orange in it, but you're gonna have to color that yourself. Now, jumping straight into articulation, for the head is basically going to be on this giant like ball joint. It's not the best and it's pretty tight, but it does its job, I suppose. The little sideburns right here are actually going to be able to move, but very little, and it's kind of just pointless. The ponytail is going to be on a little ball joint so that can move around. This collar piece is actually not plugged into anything, and it's going to be a little annoying just having that flop around. Shoulders are going to be on ball joints. Can move up. You get a bicep swivel. One point of articulation for the elbow. Hands are going to be on ball joints. Torso is going to be on a ball joint. The skirt can move independently. Waist can move back and forth. Now the hips are going to be on ball joints, and with the skirt, you're not getting much of a spread. Thigh can rotate. The thigh can rotate. One point of articulation for the knee. And the foot is going to be on this little peg system and can move up and down, so pretty good bends overall, as well as the ankle pivots. Now, when it comes to poses, you can do a lot of great things, like in cutesy little poses. You can put her in some little action poses, some quirky poses, but it's not to the extent of what like most mecha can do. So you're going to have to do your pose game a little bit different than what you would normally do with, like, say, Gundam or, you know, maybe Macross or something. Now, for faceplates and eyes, she is going to have this kind of, like, smiling face. And she's going to have this more serious tone faceplate, but it's going to carry over the same eyes from before. This really cute winking face. They also have a blank eye place, that way you can use this for painting, and you can place the water slides right on here. Now for hands, she is going to come with the solid fist hands, only a right hand pointing finger, and two open hands with the fingers extended and joined. And the last thing we can do is just put her in the classic Mega Man style. Now with the classic look, what is different? First thing is that the little collar part is going to be taken off, and this right here, this little top part, is going to have to be painted white if you're going to want that color accuracy. Next, her sleeve shirt arm is going to be replaced with a skin tone arm. And lastly, her boots are going to be replaced with more skin tone, as well as these sandals. And I forgot to mention, her hair is going to be different. This one's going to have the articulated sideburns, and these are going to be fixed. Now, it does suck that she does not come with any stand or any adapters to put on her stand, and she doesn't have any kind of ports that can plug a stand into. But if you have the little claw adapter like most Figma stands have, you can easily just put her on the claw and it's good. So what are my final thoughts on this kit? Honestly, it is a good purchase. I love the fact that she looks great out of the box. She doesn't really need any extra work, even without the white on the chest whenever she's in her classic mode, or the orange on the boots. She is still a great looking figure that really doesn't need any work. I would recommend just hitting it with a matte coat. If you want to do some shading, you can do shading on a straight build using some pastels. But I really don't feel the need to paint this kit. It looks good as is. And I'm just going to put it in my Mega Man collection and call it a day. So for you guys, if you really want Roll or some kind of Mega Man Classic or even Mega Man 8 representation, then I think this is going to be a great kit to add to your collection. Even if you are a novice or beginner builder, trust me, this kit is super simple. It took me maybe a few hours to build, and for you it probably take you quicker, because if you don't go to the in-depths of sanding and try and fine-tune every single thing, this kit is going to be super fast for you to build. I just take a little bit extra time just to clean up all the nub marks to make sure none are visible. And side note, this kit is actually going to have a couple of seam lines, so if you are the kind of person who wants to paint this kit as well as remove seam lines, you're going to have not only the seam lines on the head, but you're going to have the seam lines on the arms, the hands, as well as all the legs. So you are going to have to get to sanding if you're going to want to remove all those. Not really difficult, but it's going to take a little bit of, I would say, modding on the arms. The legs are going to be fine. You can easily seam line remove those and paint them all up. But for the arms in particular, it's going to be a little bit tricky to get those seam lines removed and have the kit completed with painted and all that. So other than that, it's a beautiful build. I love it. If you can find it for, I would say, less than $30, definitely go ahead and pick it up. Otherwise, anything more than like $30, it's a little bit too much for something that doesn't come with a lot of accessories. But that's it for me, guys. So thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe if you have not already, and let me know in the comment section below what you think about this kit. Is it something you're going to build? Is it something that you want to get? Or is there another kit that you really wish Kotobukiya would tackle in the Mega Man franchise? But that's it for me. I'll be seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.